Well, hi, everybody, and welcome to Moodle Support Theater for version 2.3. This series is going to deal with the gradebook, and this series is designed for you to watch each video in succession because each presentation builds on the last. Now, there's a couple of things I want to point out about the gradebook. First, you're not required to use Moodle to do your grading. This is here as a convenience for both you and your students. If you have a highly complex gradebook, I'd recommend Excel as an excellent choice. If you're going to use Excel, you need to know you must first set your gradebook up in Moodle and then export it to Excel. Utilize it as you see fit, and you can then import your content back into Moodle. It is still not possible to import directly from Excel into a blank gradebook. It's just not going to work. We will cover this in detail in one of our subsequent videos. There are some things that, no matter which of the Moodle methods you use, by doing these things, you're going to reduce your frustration and ensure your success. So here in the gradebook class, I have minimized in the left-hand column the navigation block. I'm in the settings block, and here it says grades. I'm going to give it a click, and it'll take us to our gradebook, and by golly, that doesn't look so much different than the other one did. I have some sample students here on the left. I created one assignment from the front page in advance. I'm going to come to the top and go to Categories and Items. And here's a basic gradebook. Now, as it's set, it says Simple Weighted Means of Grades. I'm going to use the drop-down. We only have three to worry about. Weighted Means of Grades, that is the most complex and robust. Simple, which I predict about 90% of the campus will be using. And Sum of Grades, which should be the simplest, but as you, of course, come to expect, there are some little surprises with that. Each of those videos is going to follow. If you're going to be using any of these methods, I recommend adding a category. And to do that, we come to the bottom of the page. It makes it much more clear for students, and it makes it much more clear for you what belongs where. So I'm selecting Add a Category. I'm going to call my first category Reading. And in my class, I give each block of assignments a value. Reading is worth 30% of the total grade. My aggregation, I'm going to choose Simple Weighted Means of Grades and aggregate only non-empty grades as indicated by the little check in the box. For the rest of the things, I'm going to leave them alone and choose Save Changes. Here I have my reading assignment and I have my reading category. The assignment is outside of the category. I did that to show you it's not the end of the world. We come all the way over to the right-hand column. There we see Select, and there's a checkbox. By putting a check in the checkbox, I can now go down to the bottom of the page, and under the Save Changes button, it says Move Selected Items To, and by using the drop-down, there it is. I click on Reading 30%, and the item is automatically moved inside of the category. I do recommend you use Save Changes after you complete a series of actions, and I also suggest you do this fairly frequently. Now, let's say you decide you don't want to use the reading category, or you're going to call it something else. Notice in the reading category, there's Simple Weighted Means of Grades, and we follow it over. Here are the icons in the Actions section, and one of the things you can do, in addition to using the hand holding the pencil to correct any typos, you can delete this category. And by doing that, we select the X, give it a click, a message will pop up saying, do you want to delete that? Yes, you may delete a category, and notice when we get back to the main page, your assignment is still preserved. You will not wipe out an assignment by deleting a category. I'm going to put the category back, so I choose Add Category. I give it a name. I'm going to call it Reading. I'm going to make it worth 30%. And remember, that 30% is just typing. It has no actual value. Simple Weighted Means of Grades. We have a check mark. And we're saving our changes. Here's my item. I'm going to put a check in the box and move it to the Reading category. And there we are. I recommend a category for each group of activities. You'll see how we develop this as we continue. reading, research, participation, that type of thing. And we'll talk about dealing with these pesky numbers. Notice the category total may not agree exactly with what you think it should be. All of this is easily fixable. So come on back to the Gradebook series. If you need help between now and then, come on by Moodle Support. We're in Library 315 and available at extension 3633.